the evening, President Nicolae Ceausescu and his wife gave an official dinner in honor of President Richard Nixon and his wife at the State Council. The dinner, which was attended by Romanian and American officials, took place in a warm and cordial atmosphere. Two presidents made toasts. Our countries, President Nicolae Ceausescu said, are states with different social systems, but we consider that the differences of our social systems must not hinder the development of collaboration among nations. Romania, as a socialist country, places in the center of her foreign policy the multilateral cooperation with the socialist countries. She develops at the same time fruitful relations in all fields with the other countries of the world. President Ceausescu underlined the concern of the Romanian state and government for extinguishing the hotbeds of war in the world, expressing the hope that the Paris talks would lead to the cessation of the war in Vietnam, for the affirmation of the right to free existence of the Vietnam people, for the lessening of tension and the instauration of a climate of confidence and peace in the world. "We stand ready," President Nixon said, "to consider all the concrete possibilities to reduce tension. We are in favor of negotiations on all litigious problems with a view to improve the present situation, to promote security for us all." Thanking for the welcome and the warm words at the address of the American people, President Nixon toasted for friendship and many-sided cooperation between our peoples. At the Council of Ministers, the President of the State Council, Nicolae Ceausescu, and his wife gave a reception in honor of President Richard Nixon and his wife. The reception, which was attended by Romanian and American officials, by heads of the diplomatic missions, and by numerous journalists, took place in an atmosphere of full cordiality. On Sunday, August the 3rd, President Richard Nixon, accompanied by his Romanian hosts, visited the capital of Romania. A first halt was made at the Obor Market, the biggest of Bucharest. The meetings and talks with the shop assistants, with the citizens who were shopping, gave the distinguished guests the possibility to know various aspects of the everyday life of the town. The official convoy then left for the Titan district, an urban district recently built in Bucharest. 40,000 flats were built there in the last few years, and another 30,000 are under construction. In a talk with the architects of the town, President Nixon appreciated the architectural style of this dwelling district, conceived, as the president said, with much imagination and concern for the best living conditions. Continuing the visit of Bucharest, the official convoy set for the village museum. the authentic image of Romanian folk art offered by this original cultural settlement was completed by the songs and dances performed by folk groups and orchestras. The distinguished guests could thus get to know some of the specific traits of the Romanian folklore, the joy of life, and the thirst for the beauty of the people living between the Danube and the Carpathian Mountains. These images are familiar with at least a quarter of a million of Americans who, as President Nixon said, have one or both parents born in Romania. The distinguished guest seems to have taken a great interest in the Romanian narr, or panpipe. At the end of the visit, President Nixon, President Ceausescu and the other guests joined the dancers in a lively Romanian folk dance called the horror. Sunday afternoon, President Richard Nixon concluded his visit to Romania. Thousands of people came to see off the distinguished guest at the Otopeni Airport. Guard of Honor performs the departure ceremony.
Bună ziua, soldat!
President Nixon takes farewell from the heads of the diplomatic missions, from the Romanian officials present at the airport. A message of greeting to America from its sons in Bucharest, the members of the United States Embassy. It has been my privilege to visit 60 countries in the world, and of all the countries I have visited, none has been more memorable than my visit to Romania, President Nixon said in his departure speech. Upon your return to your homeland, President Ceausescu said, I should like you to convey on my own behalf, on behalf of the Romanian people, our friendly greetings to the people of America, our best wishes for prosperity and peace. And now, please allow me to bid you bon voyage, Mr. President. Flowers of friendship and esteem, warm gestures were added to the words of satisfaction for the visit of the American President in Romania, a contribution to the promotion of international relaxation of collaboration among states. And this, and we again take the liberty to quote President Nixon, both due to the talks we have had which will serve the cause of peace, and it is true also because of the wonderfully heartwarming welcome we have received from the people of Romania every place we have gone. When you read these snapshots of your visit to Romania, Mr. President, please think that to the Romanian people, they will be as memorable. We place your visit in the series of contacts among state and government leaders, contacts which have proved to be useful for the development of some bilateral relations of confidence and collaboration, and necessary to the improvement of the international political climate in conformity with the major interests of peace in the world.